What's up, guys? It's MB Boxing. I just finished up watching Alexis Rocha versus Giovanni Santillan, and this was a 12-rounder in the welterweight division. And this fight was Saturday, October 21st, from the Kia Forum in Inglewood, California. And this fight was broadcasted on DAZN. And in this fight, boxing is boxing, which is what we saw, where Giovanni Santillan absolutely dominated and stopped the heavily favored Alexis Rocha, stopping him in 6 rounds, destroying him. I mean, he dominated him throughout this fight. I gotta admit, it was an excellent fight, very fun fight to watch, but Santillan was just beating Rocha to the punch. Even though Rocha was throwing punches back, it was just the bigger and harder shots from Santillan. Santillan now improves to 32-0. Rocha drops to 23-2. Rocha going into this fight was an almost 7-1 favorite, and I thought he should have won most likely on points. So just again to how I had this fight scored, I had it 50-43 in favor of Santillan. And to take you guys through my scorecard, the first round, Santillan came out pressing forward on Rocha, was throwing huge overhand lefts, and Rocha just didn't have any defense for it. He was just eating massive overhand lefts over the top from Santillan, just taking them. Rocha had some big shots himself in the first, but Santillan was firing huge overhand lefts. Then in the second round, Santillan started out again with more huge left hands, and the nose of Rocha started to bleed. And then again, the first and second rounds were kind of similar, where Santillan would throw huge left hands and Rocha would have some of his good work in the round, but it was that those big power shots, the more effective shots from Santillan, that was winning him the rounds. Then round number three, Santillan was just sort of overpowering Rocha. Rocha was getting outworked in the clinch, outworked on the inside, was just getting outworked overall in terms of the heavier and better shots. Then in round number four, it was a very fun round. Both of them had very good work, but Santillan had just had the harder shots overall. Then in the fifth round, there was a great combination to the head, like a three-punch combination to the head, followed by another right hook that sent Alexis Rocha down to the canvas. He got back up, and Santillan went in for the kill, was just throwing huge combinations, and Rocha was absorbing massive combinations. Then the second knockdown, it was sort of a multiple hook combination, like 3 to 4, maybe even 5 hooks in a row that sent Rocha down again. So it was a 10-7 round in the fifth. Then in round number six, where the fight ended, it was a huge uppercut and some hooks to the head, sending Alexis Rocha down to the canvas on his knees, and the referee waved it off from there. A dominant display of Giovanni Santillan. And, I mean, really, this goes into the question, what is next for him? Based off of this dominating performance and that Alexis Rocha was number one ranked by the WBO, we could see him ranked number one by the WBO when the new ratings come out. This was an absolutely dominating performance by him. He looked excellent in this one, and I think that in his next fight, I would not mind seeing him fight maybe in a final eliminator or for a world title eliminator for that WBO title. I know that he did beat the number one contender here, but it was not listed for an eliminator. So we could see Santillan against a highly rated WBO contender in his next fight for an eliminator. The reasons why Santillan was such a heavy underdog in this fight, he was 31-0, which is interesting. Even though he was 31-0, he was a huge underdog. But it's because in his last fight against Eric Bone, who's a known journeyman, he didn't look that great. Same against Julio Luna Avila, even though he won pretty clearly, he just didn't look that solid. And that's really been the case in a lot of his fights. Even in his fight in 2020 against Antonio DeMarco, which was very, very tight. I mean, he was like barely getting by some of these guys who aren't that stellar. And here he absolutely destroyed a top 10, a recognized top 10 ranked fighter in Alexis Rocha, winning every single round and knocking him out in 6. So for Santillan, I think he'll fight for a world title eliminator, maybe an interim title or final eliminator in his next fight for the WBO title. But as for Alexis Rocha, I think he's going to have to go back to the drawing board, get maybe 3 wins over some guys who were lower ranked like around the level of his last couple opponents, like Anthony Young, George Ashe, like guys like that that he could win easily over that have solid resumes. And then maybe he'll step it up again and try and get himself back into that top 10 state. So overall, Giovanni Santillan upsets and brutally stops Alexis Rocha to improve his record to 32-0 and to get the best victory of his career by a wide margin. And yeah, that's really it. I'm MB Boxing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.